Today, we are going to start a new series on guidelines by Supreme Court. Firstly, we will see the judgments of Delhi Domestic Working Women's Forum Virtue 1995, Volume 1, Supreme Court Cases, Miss SCC 14. In this video, we are going to discuss 13 guidelines by which we have to know how to assist rape victims. Every judge, every advocate, police, law stakeholders, and even every citizen of civic society must know these guidelines. First guideline is, the complaints of sexual assault cases should be provided with legal representation. Second guideline is, it is important to have someone who is well acquainted with the criminal justice system. Third guideline is, the role of the victim's advocate would not only be to explain to the victim the nature of the proceedings, to prepare her for the case, and to assist her in the police station and in court, but to provide her with guidance as to how she might obtain help of a different nature from other agencies, for example, mind counseling or medical assistance. Fourth guideline is, it is important to secure continuity of assistance by ensuring that the same person who looked after the complainant's interest in the police station represent her till the end of the case. Legal assistance will have to be provided at the police station since the victim of a sexual assault might very well be in a distressed state. Upon arrival at the police station, the guidance and support of a lawyer at this stage and whilst she was being questioned would be of a great assistance to her. The police should be under the duty to inform the victim of her right to representation before any questions were asked of her, and that the police report should state that the victim was so informed. A list of advocates willing to act in these cases should be kept at the police station for victims who did not have a particular lawyer in mind or whose own lawyer was unavailable. The advocate shall be appointed by the court upon application by the police at the earliest convenient moment, but in order to ensure that the victims were questioned without undue delay, advocates would be authorized to act at the police station before leave of the court was sought or obtained. In all rape trials, anonymity of the victim must be maintained as far as necessary. It is necessary, having regard to the directive principles contained under Article 38(1) of the Constitution of India, to set up Criminal Injuries Compensation Board. Rape victims frequently incur substantial financial loss. Some, for example, are too traumatized to continue in employment. Compensation for victims shall be awarded by the court on conviction of the offender and by the Criminal Injuries Compensation Board, whether or not a conviction has taken place. Last and very important guideline is, the board will take into account pain, suffering and shock as well as loss of earnings due to pregnancy and the expenses of childbirth if this occurred as a result of the rape. Thank you.